Hello, everybody. This speech, which I'm going to show, I can show in 15 minutes and 30 minutes, but it's really a one-hour speech. So bear with me if it's going to be a little fast. So first of all, I want to talk about the problem which Acronis is solving, and the problem is that computing is eating the world now, solving a lot of world problems, and computing is very, very fragile. And protecting it is complex, it's expensive, it's very important at all times to remember about security. Security is now, cybercrime is now industrialized. It's super important to remember about privacy. And not only computing is effectively essential need for everyone. And for that, Acronis came up with cyber protection. There are similarities between biological hazards and computer hazards, digital hazards. And in both cases, you need to do all the things together: prevention, detection, response, recovery, and forensic. Only then you are fully protected. Most of the time, you're best protected if nothing ever happens. And most of the time, in order for nothing ever happen, you need to actually do forensic. So this is actually a circle. For that, Acronis came up with integrated and autonomous cyber protection. And Acronis' mission is to protect all data applications and systems. Safety, accessibility, privacy, authenticity, and security, we call it Acronis Cyber SAPOS. In such way, it is only possible to create a solution which is easy, low cost, secure, leave control in the hands of the customers, and it's reliable. And effectively, Acronis does one thing: autonomous integrated model of cyber protection for customers, offered through cyber cloud, through partners, service providers, based on cyber platform, so it can be extended, integrated, and customized, using Acronis cyber infrastructure, so it's local to your business, and it's very, very cost effective and easy, and augmented with Acronis services. With that, Acronis is headquartered in Schaffhausen, in the same place as SAT, and has second headquarters in Singapore, and it's medium-sized company with expertise specifically in cyber protection, cyber engine, which includes security and intelligent, artificial intelligence, computer science, software engineering, because it's a large platform. Building platform is the best thing you can do if you're a software engineer. And in specific expertise related to basically usage of artificial intelligence in different human fields. However, this is just one problem we're facing. There are some more general problems which are facing the world: diseases, environment, social justice, wars and violence, space universe challenges. You know, my favorite problem is aging. I really am not looking forward towards my birthday, which is less than 2 weeks from now. And for what we know about the universe is a computer. And computers can be used to predict just about everything in the universe. On the right, we have an example of making drug discovery using computers. Almost all drug discovery are done by computers right now. What is a computer? Digital computers, which we use today, are effectively equivalent to Turing machines. So all this advanced technology, CPUs, GPUs, TPUs with tens of billions of transistors are just 2D or 3D versions of 1D Turing machines. And there is limitations. There's not going to be 4D. With that, there is already an evolution of digital computers, which actually is building specialized computers for specialized needs, such as neuromorphic computers, which are designed for deep learning, machine learning. Photonic computers, which are also very good for deep learning, for machine learning, because they're very, very, they have very, very high frequency, and they are very good for simple, highly parallel operations. Many of those computers are already shipping. But with digital computers, we will hit hard limits before we solve some really hard problems. The well-known Moore law is no longer working. It's no longer possible to double number of transistors every 24 months. And with digital transistor computers, we will hit performance through output limits, power consumption limits, and the computer size limits. The well-known complexity theorist Scott Aronson estimates that we will hit those limits in 25 years, and there are fundamental limits on the left, which will be hit regardless in relatively short time, 75 years or 60 years, based on our estimates. There are these two simple problems. One of them is many body problems in physics, effectively predicting how the nature behaves and how the materials behave. And another problem is large integral primer factorization, And you can easily came up with systems which can never be solved on any digital computer which can possibly produce. So there is upcoming revolution. There are new kinds of computing, quantum computing, such as this computer, which was the first computer breaking any possible record of digital computer, which was available last year. This is three examples of most popular architectures and groups of guys who are building quantum computers. All these quantum computers are already in some form available today. You can do some calculations on them. There are more futuristic designs like black hole computers or advanced material computers. On the right, again, you can either theorize about black hole computers or you can actually see some advanced materials computers already today. Advanced materials is a very perspective way to approach computers. Ultimately, most advanced computer is a human body and brain, and that computer can solve some unbelievably complex problems which we do not know today how to solve on the conventional machine, just consuming 10 watts of power and weighing 1.5 kilo. Reality is that we need some advanced computers very, very soon. We need it for robust sensors and actuators. We need it for quantum internet. We need it for advanced material simulations. We desperately need better materials. We need to have better storage. We have a lot of data and we want to augment human bodies. This is just one example of quantum internet. Reality is that the only way to keep the secret is to use quantum internet. And for that, you need quantum repeaters, which is a small quantum computer. The good thing about this new generation computers, they can be plugged into the world computing architecture very, very easily. You have CPU, GPU, TPU plugged in today. You probably have Memristor Array and Photonics also somewhere in Google, Amazon, and for example, Microsoft Clouds. Quantum computers will be plugged in and available real soon, if not yet, and they can plug in all these computers. However, to build these computers, there are a number of interdisciplinary problems to solve. First of all, new computers will require new advanced materials. Then new computers will require new, completely different hardware. New computers will require new, completely different software. New computers will require completely new software to not only design them, but also to run them, and new, completely different application software. And for that, we decided to build SIT, which is Computer Physics and Business, which is a small focused university. I want to basically, this is a slide I'm showing for the first time. This is the idea of SIT. SIT is driving technology and education business to generate unconstrained funding and other value needed to produce world-class science. So the core of SIT is SIT Foundation and SIT University, which are non-profit. But next to SIT and in SIT, there is a for-profit SIT holding, which includes this interesting nine members SIT Zone, which is producing a variety of different services for technology and science companies and its members. SIT Transformation Consulting, SIT Autonomous, SIT Alimira, and SIT Academy. And this very, very profitable and highly commercial companies produce founding, developing funding and service and tech needed for SIT Foundation to fund SIT University, versus SIT University produces reputation, people, knowledge, IP services needed to fund those companies. And this all operation is based in SIT Zone, which is both physical and virtual, and both global and local. But of course, the headquarter and the main place for SIT is Schaffhausen today. The focus of SIT University is just this three high-level fields, computer physics and business sciences. I want to stop for a second on computers and physics. So cybersecurity and information integrity, artificial intelligence and machine learning, software engineering, robotic and autonomous machines. These specific fields in physics, quantum technology and advanced materials in business is basically applying computers and physics to various human problems. And examples of those problems are here, digital health, new generation business management, digital learning and education, AI in arts and design, and so forth and so on. I want to point out that almost none of the modern problems are solved by any of those disciplines alone. Almost every project, such as, for example, highly desired autonomous cars, are only possible to be built with an interdisciplinary approach. And you need to have at least some people who understand to some extent, every field of these approaches to actually solve the problems of building autonomous cars. How can we do it? Well, first of all, we do it in a partnership with Carnegie Mellon University and National University of Singapore. Second of all, we do it with a group of advanced individuals who allocate some of their attention and time to help this. And this is the most important part of the university. This is a scientist involved, members of strategic advisory boards. On the physics side, Kostya Novoselov, who is a Nobel Prize winner, he'll speak later today, Misha Lukin, Harvard University professor, expert in quantum technology, building the most advanced quantum computer, today, Nicolas Jezan, who built the most advanced quantum communications, people in a computer science field, people in the business science field from leading universities, leading scientists. Also, of course, members of our board, members of our executive management, members of our industry connection, and variety of our friends who are helping the university, contributing hours, and ready to be participating in science and education process. This year, we're launching a Master of Science program. There will be more detailed speech about the program. I just want to stop on several differences. First of all, this program is targeted towards preparing enough knowledge in the leaders. We believe in the modern world, no project can be built without software. And typical software project is not small. It's 1,000 man years, 100 people, 10 to 100 releases. And so it actually is a project which requires 5 to 8 type of leaders, which are listed on the left side. But the project which you want to participate in, really successful business or science project, will include thousands of people and 10,000 of man years, and will require all the leaders on the left side. Some of those leaders are quite familiar probably to you, such as, for example, chief technology officer. Some of them are perhaps interesting. There is a big difference between chief architect and chief engineer. There is interesting roles like chief idea officer or chief science officer in any software project. And we teach how to play those roles. The second difference is, beside leading the teams of leaders, is a connection, and a connection to advanced people is transformational leadership, science of people, business sciences. We believe it's important to teach computer scientists, business scientists, quantum informatics, which we feel is the future. We feel there are going to be a lot of software to be written for quantum computers. Advanced material science, we believe, again, there's going to be a lot of software written for advanced materials and written based on advanced materials. And another thing, which we truly know how to help you to understand, is entrepreneurship. This is an alumni event, so in some ways I'm talking to people who came to listen, but I'm also talking to people who came to speak, our future alumni. They haven't graduated yet, but hopefully they will graduate real soon. And I want to stop for a second on what is entrepreneurship. So first of all, what differentiates an entrepreneur, and can you teach entrepreneurship? And you would think about these qualities: smart, high IQ, education, network, luck, hardworking. In reality, this is not really important. Many of entrepreneurs don't have any of those qualities. They don't have a good network and connections. They don't have luck. They are not super hardworking. They are not good people. However, what they have is this 11 qualities: ambition, initiative, empathy, alert, being responsive, detail-oriented, making decisions, never giving up, and as such, you don't need luck if you never give up, frequency, passion, and care. I cannot have enough time to talk about this. I think this is a good movie. If you want to be an entrepreneur, you need to be prepared to be like this guy in this movie, There Will Be Blood. Also, very often, people ask me and tell me what they do. And I want to explain how entrepreneurs actually make decisions of what they want, or what they actually do, how they build their businesses. So basically, you can do what you want, or you can do what you should, but in reality, you can only do what you can. And what you can is based on the most importantly, opportunity. And opportunity is highly dependent on your ability to execute and your ability to come up the strategy, which is a differentiation capabilities and focus for these opportunities. And if you do not have the right opportunity and you do not have the right execution skills and you not have enough strategy, instead of trying to pick something which is not ideal for you, you should go back and acquire knowledge. At some point, if you keep acquiring knowledge and execution skills, the right opportunity will come along. But it's important that you should only do what you can. And with that, I want to finish my speech almost on time. What can you do now? First of all, you can become Acronis CyberFit. Unique feature about Acronis, you can be our customer, partner, employee, engineer, and executive. We will double our headcount in the next 3 years. You can join SIT as a researcher or faculty, or you can sponsor and invest or buy SIT services. We are going to produce highly competitive services. For example, SIT Autonomous Platform and Autonomous Machine Consulting, for example, SIT Alimira. Also, SIT is actively looking for students for our unique master program, which I'm sure my colleagues will talk about today. You can apply now. Why should you apply? It's very simple. It only makes sense to apply to a program which can make you to be as successful as Alan Turing as a computer scientist, or as successful as John Bardeen as a physicist, or as successful as Larry Page and Sergey Brin in business. Thank you.